What is the world without power? It is the great irony of power. Those who understand its importance the most have the least. Those who can control it least have it all. And we fight over it every day.
Hey everyone, it's Jason from Rokland Technologies, and today we're going to be talking about the new Helium PoC v11 update. PoC, of course, stands for Proof of Coverage. Before we jump into that, though, I want to give a quick shout out to Daniel Nettlechev. Daniel is the winner of our SyncroB.it miner giveaway contest that we've been talking about all summer long. Congratulations, Daniel. And we'll be doing another miner giveaway starting with our next YouTube video. So if you haven't already hit that subscribe button, do that now so that you can find out how to enter our next miner giveaway contest. But back to the subject at hand, the proof of coverage update, it's rolling out now. It's going to be rolling out through October. There are a number of other YouTubers who have done a great job laying out exactly the steps you need to take in the Helium app to be compliant. We're going to do that a little bit later in this video as well, but first we want to talk about a topic that's very heavy on the hearts of many of our users right now, and that is power. You see, Rokland has tens of thousands of Helium antennas in use right now. A lot of our customers have reached out to us through chat and phone to ask us about this rumor that Helium might be taking the antenna gain number that you enter into your Helium app and using that number to turn down your transmit power of your miner accordingly. If you didn't know, now you know that is true. That is one of the things that Helium is going to be doing with this proof of coverage update. And you might ask yourself, why? Why would they be doing this? Why would they turn down power when power is so important? The simple answer is to be in compliance with local laws and regulations in different regions. And that has to do with EIRP. That stands for Effective Isotropic Radiated Power. The United States, the EU, and other countries, they limit this total number of power. And so Helium's got to be in compliance with that. And basically EIRP, all it really is it's your transmitter's power, the transmitter in your miner, plus the gain of your antenna, it equals a certain amount of EIRP. And as your antenna gain gets higher, that EIRP gets higher as well. So to compensate, if your gain is too high, Helium's got to turn down the EIRP so they're in compliance. So you just spent all that money on a high gain outdoor antenna, cable setup, and now you find out Helium might be turning down your power? All right, let's go ahead and panic. That felt better. Well, the good news is there's really no reason to panic at all, especially if you're here in the United States. Let's say you have a Rokland brand 8 dBi antenna or lower gain, 8 dBi or lower gain antenna. Here's exactly how much power you're going to lose after Helium turns on this PoC update. Are you ready for it? We're going to put it up on the screen for you. You're going to lose exactly, that's right, you're not going to lose any power at all. You see, here in the United States, the EIRP limits are so high that even with an 8 dBi antenna, you're not going to exceed those limits. Now, what about a 10 dBi or a 12 dBi antenna? Well, this is where it's important to take into account cable laws. Okay, if you bought a coaxial cable from Rokland, right on our product pages, we show you exactly how much cable loss you get from using a coaxial cable. We use very good shielding, so the cable loss isn't as much, but for, say, a 16 or a 25 foot cable or something like that, you may have about 1 dB of loss. So if you're using a 10 dBi antenna, you're able to subtract that 1 dB and you're able to enter 9 in the Helium app. So you still won't have your power turned down if you're putting in the correct cable loss number. Now let's head over to Europe for a moment. For friends in Europe, the power limits are a little bit more stringent. We found out that they're actually 16 dBm. Okay, some websites say 27, but that appears to be on the G3 band from 863 to 870 for Helium. We've confirmed directly from the Helium engineering blog that they actually, earlier this year in January, they had to turn down the power of the Rack V2 miners to 14 dBm. Because the factory antenna is 2 dBi gain and 14 plus 2 equals 16 dBm of EIRP. So what does that mean for you in Europe? Okay, Rokland is coming out later this year with an 868 megahertz antenna for Europe. It's going to be 6 dBi gain for outdoor use. Now when you use that 6 dBi antenna with your Helium miner in Europe, what does that mean? Okay, well if you use it with a cable that say has 1 dB loss, that's 5 plus 14 from the miner, that's 19 dBm. And what do we know? We know the restriction is 16 dBm. Therefore, with this new POC update, Helium's gonna turn your miner power down by 3 dBm in Europe, okay? So that means you shouldn't get a 6 dBi antenna, right? Not at all, okay? What you have to remember is that your power is not going to be lower with a higher gain antenna. Your max EIRP with a 6 dBi antenna will still be the same as your max EIRP with a lower gain antenna, but you have the extra gain. You have that 6 dBi of gain. And that's true here in the United States as well. If you're using a 10 or a 12 dBi, you're going to have that extra gain number. And that's going to matter when you get your antenna outside above the roof or tree line. We can't tell you how much elevation matters. It's going to make a huge difference when you're trying to pick up and connect with a hotspot many kilometers away. To have that extra gain higher up outside, it's going to be critical. So the bottom line is, here in the United States, there's really nothing to worry about with power laws. In the European Union, you're going to be losing a little bit of power, but that doesn't mean you should not get a high gain antenna, because you're still going to have some benefit from that extra gain. But it's very important to take into account your cable loss when setting up the Helium app. So to find out exactly what you need to do to configure your Helium app correctly for this update and to take into account for cable loss, we're going to turn over to John now, who's going to walk us through the process step by step.
Hey guys, this is John with Rokland Technologies. We're going to show you how to update your antenna settings within the Helium Hotspot app. In this case, we're going to show this on some iPhone screenshots. So the first thing you want to do to make sure your hotspot is asserted in the correct location is to click on Update Hotspot. So we're going to click there. And then after we've put in the correct location, we're going to want to assert our antenna gain. Now, most manufacturers have already provided their standard gains, but if you've ordered a Rokland antenna or another custom antenna, you're going to want to go ahead and put in the DBI that we have listed. To do this, we're going to simply click on Custom Antenna. Now, it is important to take into account cable loss. So on all of our cable pages, we have listed the cable loss in dB. So go ahead and take that number and subtract it from the antenna's DBI value. If you've gotten a cable from a different supplier, you can reach out to them to get that dB value. And then finally, we're going to come down to enter in our antenna's height above the ground if we would like to do so. It's actually not going to be used in proof of coverage 11, but it might be a good idea to go ahead and put this in there. And that's it. So now your hotspot's antenna settings are correctly updated within the Helium app. If you guys have any questions, just reach out to us on the live chat or send us an email, and we're happy to go over this with you.
Somewhere in the dark forest of power that has trapped many civilizations, the light of hope shines through, and the winds of change blow the determined man further toward his destiny. Let the People's Network guide us all to the New World Order.